Good morning, everybody. Welcome to Riata Horsemanship. I'm Luke Brown, and today is Training Tip Tuesday. I have something kind of cool to show you today. The horse that I'm riding this morning is Duke again. I think I did a video with him yesterday. And as you can see my left hand, I'm not using the reins at all with my hands. And I'm working on some leg pressure cues and getting him to turn and getting him to circle with just my leg pressure. Now, I've been working with him about 15 minutes up to this point, and this is the first time I've done this, and he's getting fairly good at it. Horses can learn very quickly, especially horses like him. He's just smart, and I wanted to talk to you about using leg cues and cueing in general. I remember last week I talked about the buttons, or maybe it was a couple weeks ago. I think it's a couple weeks ago. I talked about buttons, that the more buttons a horse has, the safer that horse is, because the more things that horse has learned to listen to your cue and then respond appropriately without overreacting. So the more buttons a horse has, I believe that the more safe that horse is going to be. He just listens more. And it's kind of like if you can get a horse and walk forward with a horse, maybe they're in kindergarten. But if you can do flying lead changes and you can back up in circles and do counter arcs at a back, or you can just ride your horse without a bridle, up to riding your horse bridleless, you're getting to, you know, the college level of your horse's training. And so the further along they go, the better they're going to get and the safer they're going to get, as long as you give them the right training. And so Duke is, as I mentioned yesterday, he's in his second month of training with me. He just came back for some more training, a little more refined training. He's doing really well, a very safe horse to ride. And in fact, my nieces are coming in the next couple days, my brother and his wife and my parents and my nieces, and I'm gonna have them ride him, because, and they're the age of like 10 to 13 or 10 to 12, and he's just a very safe horse. So as far as the buttons go and using your leg cues, there are two ways you can go about teaching a horse to turn, and that is, one, putting the rein on first and then putting your leg on. And the second way is putting your leg on first and then putting the rein on. And the difference is what you want ultimately that horse to do. If you ultimately want to just ride bridleless and you want that horse to go off of your leg cues, then you're going to teach the horse you're going to use a leg cue first and then your rein to turn your horse. If you want the horse, most of the horses that I train are for people who aren't expert riders. Most of them are beginner riders or intermediate riders. And so what I do is I teach them the rein first, because managing the rein is a lot easier than managing your legs when it comes to the skill level of the rider. So if a rider can just hang on to the saddle and rein the horse, and the horse can turn and stop, then that horse is going to be pretty safe for the rider. But here with Duke, he has a rider that is inexperienced, but because I'm going through more in-depth training with him, I've just been working with more buttons with him, and that includes this morning working on turning him without having to use my reins. Now, this whole time I've been talking, I've been turning him right to left, and I'm not using my reins, I'm just using my legs. Now, let me tell you how I do it. So when I first start with this, of course, a horse needs to learn how to directional rein. First and foremost, they got a directional rein. They've got to get soft laterally and directional rein. Then I teach them to move their shoulders in and out. And then I teach them to neck rein. And then after they neck rein and they can move their shoulders in and out, and they can side pass and yield their hindquarters, yield their forequarters, they understand leg cues and they understand rein cues. Then I start playing with them and getting to the point where they can move off of just leg cues. And it's really fun to do. So what I'll do is, if I'm going to turn left, like right now I'm turning left, you'll see how he's circling to the left here. Now I'm going to pick up a left again, ask him to turn. There he goes. He's turning. Now, how am I doing that? It's hard to see because you can't really see my feet. But what I'm doing, if I'm turning left, I'm going to put my right calf up towards his girth area, my left calf back towards his flank area, or that first button and the third button. So first button is on the right leg, third button's on the left. So what I'm doing is I'm gonna try to bend him around my left leg, and I'm kind of pushing the shoulders to the left, and I'm bending his ribs on the left side. So pushing the shoulders on the right to the left, pushing him to the left, but on the right side, and then bending his ribs on the left, and I'm bending him around. So I'm not asking him to do a shoulder yield or a forequarter yield. I'm asking him to bend in a circle to the left. And now let's see if I can go right. So I'm putting my left leg, and you see him going right. So now he's going back to the right. I put my left leg up near the girth and my right leg back towards that back cinch right there. And then he turns. What I do initially is I give him that cue and I'll wait about two to three seconds initially. I want to give him time to really think about where my legs are. So I put give him that cue, and then if he doesn't turn left, let's say I'm trying to turn left, so my right leg goes up towards his girth, my left leg goes back towards his hind cinch or his back cinch, and not past the cinch typically at this point, but just in front of that cinch in that third button. And then as if he doesn't turn left, or if he tries to speed up, I'm going to pick up on that left rein and directional rein him to the left. And I'm going to wait until he softens and bends to the left and then let him out of it. And then we'll walk for a while. And then I'm going to use the leg cues again. And then wait 2 or 3 seconds, if he doesn't do it, I'm going to pick up that rein, that inside rein on the left side, and ask him to bend to the left. And it took me about probably 5 or 6 minutes of doing that until he finally figured out, he's thinking, when I feel the legs in that position, I need to turn. And so that's how I got him to do it. And it's a lot of fun once you start learning all to teach the horse these buttons. And there's a lot of people out there that love to ride bridleless, and it's quite the show when you can sit on a horse and ride him around without any bridle, any kind of device that goes on their head or even on their neck, and just use your seat and your legs. And it's pretty awesome. And I'm not to the level of talent that somebody like some of the great trainers out there are. I don't do much bridleless besides in the saddle. I don't do it bareback for sure, because I just don't feel like I have the seat that I need for that. But maybe one of these days I'll get to that point. But I hope today's tip was kind of interesting to you, and I hope you start to, if your horse can do all the things that I mentioned, if they can yield the forequarters, yield the hindquarters, side pass, if they stop well, if they directional rein well, and if they neck rein well, then you can start working on that leg yield. And then now on the flip side, if I want him to learn to leg yield first, then I'm gonna ask with the leg and then tell with the rein. Ask with the leg, tell with the rein. And eventually when I ask with the leg, he's gonna do it. Now I got to that point now, but I kind of went through the back door to get there. I hope that's not too confusing to you, but we'll talk more about that in other videos, and videos that we're gonna have me being filmed from the ground and I'm not up here and you can actually see what I'm doing. Hope that helped for you guys today. I hope you have a wonderful day. Hope you have fun riding your horse, and make sure to be thankful, live with purpose, live with passion, and as always, stay safe in the saddle.